According to our previous lecture, we have already completed the segment of MA1. The chapter we have already gone through. I provide you all kinds of notes, right? The notes actually composed of, or notes actually, you can say, it will cover MA1, MA2, and F2. The notes I have provided you, it will cover all the things. The fact is, up to the last class, we have covered the MA1 segment. And this segment also you get in MA2 as well as in F2. From today, I'm just going to start MA2. In this current one, I will go through the MA2, the syllabus of MA2, and make some revisions of MA1 for the last time. So this is, you can say F2, or you can say this is part of MA2. The lecture I am going to throw from today, this is part of F2 or MA2. First of all, today we will go through the CVP analysis. CVP analysis, cost, volume, profit analysis. So what do you mean by this CVP analysis? Volume of production, that is according to decision, according to strategy, when you take the decision how much or how many you are going to produce or sell, that is actually volume of production. With this volume of production, two different things is related. One is profit, and another is cost. See, if you want to produce more, you require more cost. If you take the decision to lessen your production, it will reduce the cost required. At the same time, if you can sell more, if you can generate more revenue, it will generate more profit. So this profit and cost are related with the volume of production and sale. So in this chapter, this is one of the most important chapters in MA2 as well as F2. In this chapter, we try to make a relationship, financial relationship, or you can say that is manager relationship between these three components. And depend upon that relationship, we make some future forecasting or make some decision. Clear? So that's why the chapter name is CVP analysis. That means we are going to make some manager relationship regarding cost and profit with volume of production. Okay. Here, at the very first stage, we will discuss what do you mean by BEP, which is called break even point. Break even. Break-even point. In doing CVP analysis, this break-even point is one of the most important factor in different kinds of decision we are going to make through this CVP analysis. So first of all, we need to know what do you mean by this break-even point. If you are a businessman, so think yourself you are dealing with some specific kind of business. In every cases, your first concern is to generate profit, right? Then, focusing generating profit, at the same time, it is your question, that is, how much minimum or how many minimum, at least, that is minimum one can say at least, that you have to produce, you have to sell, so that you can overcome your fixed cost. Or so that there will be no sort of profit or loss. Being a business people, it is the first question, that is minimum sales or minimum quantity to be produced so that there will be no kinds of profit or loss. Profit will generate afterwards. So BP will provide you break-even point, will provide you a certain point when there will be no profit, no loss. In the previous chapter, we have discussed about contribution and profit. Suppose take an example. Suppose sales, your sale is, suppose, $100. Contribution, contribution was suppose as for example $60. Suppose variable cost is suppose as for example $60. So when you are deducting this variable cost from the sales, it will provide you contribution $40. And the discussion was that this is the amount from which you have to contribute your fixed cost first. After contributing the fixed cost, if anything remain, that will be regarded as a kind of profit, right? So now we are talking about the break-even point. Break-even point is a certain point. It's a certain point. It will provide you the minimum amount of sales required or minimum number of units that you have to sell so that you can be reaching your position where there will be no sort of profit, no sort of loss. That means for theoretical basis, you can say, suppose your fixed cost, that means at BP, you can assume that your profit will be zero, loss will be zero, profit will be zero, no sort of profit, no sort of loss. So if fixed cost is 40, then you can say profit is zero, right? It's the kind of situation. So from this contribution means per unit into number of sales or quantity, where this contribution equal to fixed cost, only then you can go to the break-even point, right? Because we have discussed that is at break-even point my profit will be zero. When the profit will be zero? Your profit will be zero only when your contribution and fixed cost will be equal, right? So at BP you can say contribution, total contribution and total fixed cost must be equal. So you can find out this Q. So you can say this Q equal to fixed cost divided by contribution per unit. Here, this is one approach. So you can say this is fixed cost divided by this is contribution per unit. Contribution per unit means selling price per unit minus variable cost per unit, which will provide you the contribution per unit. So this will be your break-even quantity. This is one approach how you can find out the Q. And another thing is, that is, you can say at BP break-even point, your total revenue and total cost will be equal, so that there will be no sort of profit and loss. If the cost and revenue are equal, then there will be no sort of profit or loss, right? So you can start this equation. That is, at my BP, my total revenue and total cost will be equal. Here, I'm just trying to find out my BP quantity, that is least or minimum how many you have to sell and produce so that you can reach at this position, right? When your TR and TC will be equal. Now the fact is TR, total revenue is, that is the total amount comes by selling the specific amount of quantity. Here we are assuming that we have produced Q quantity. Suppose as for example the selling price per unit is P. So TR will be BQ. right? By selling par unit, you are getting P dot. So when you are selling Q quantity, the total revenue will be PQ. And from the earlier stage, cost classification, we have discussed TC means variable cost plus fixed cost. And here you are producing Q and Q unit. So the total cost equal to VQ plus FC. So we have already discussed that is like BEP. BEP means a position when your total revenue and total cost will be equal. So from this equation we can find out Q, right? If you find out Q, it will be FC divided by Q minus B. So Q equal to fixed cost divided by selling price per unit minus variable cost per unit equal to contribution per unit. So we can find out the BEP quantity, that means minimum amount that you have to produce, that you have to sell, that is Q, is fixed cost divided by contribution per unit. It will provide you a number of unit. Number of unit. That means you have to sell, produce and sell at least this number so that you can reach at a position where there will be no question of profit and loss. Afterwards, this BEP. Now, think yourself, if you can find out or calculate this BEP, BEP quantity. Suppose you are the manager, production manager. You have to forecast the future number of production. So what your budget, how much or how many you are going to produce in the next forthcoming period. So set up this budget. This budget obviously should be more than this Q. Because at this Q you can overcome all kinds of cost. And afterwards you can assume that there will be some profit. So your budgeted production must be more than this Q, right? Okay. Now, when you have BEP quantity, we have already found out that is fixed cost divided by selling price per unit, variable cost per unit, right? Now, you have to find out BEP sales volume. What do you mean by this BEP sales volume? BEP sales volume equal is the amount that you can have as a kind of revenue by selling the BEP quantity in the market. Clear? The BEP quantity, when you are selling the BEP quantity in the market, it will create some revenue, and that is actually BEP. Sales volume. So you can say here, according to our example, we are producing Q quantity to appraise ourselves in the BEP, right? So by selling this Q quantity to the market, as for example, by selling price per unit is P, your total sales revenue will be P Q, right? So if you have BEP quantity, then you can find out BEP sales volume if you have the selling price per unit, right? So this is one way, and it will be amount of dollar and it will be number of units. Clear? This BEP sales volume also can be found out, or you can find out by other rules or formula, you can say, that is fixed cost divided by CS ratio. So what do you mean by this CS ratio? CS ratio. It is also called PV ratio, profit volume ratio. CS ratio, contribution to sales ratio, or profit to volume ratio. Both are the same. Even it is called profit margin. So, what do you mean by contribution to sales ratio? CS ratio. CS ratio, suppose as for example, is 20%. What does it mean? That is, if your sales is $100, within that $100, $20 will be the contribution and remaining $80 will be the variable cost. Because you can say, that is, if the sales is $100, right,
$100. Within this $100, contribution will be $20 and variable cost will be $80.
So CS ratio represent the percentage of contribution within the sale, as well as indirectly it represents the percentage of variable cost within the sale, right? So in this example, if the sales is 100, within 100 your variable cost is 80% and contribution is 20%. So by using the CS ratio, you can find out the BEP sales volume directly. That is, here you can find out BEP sales volume. You can use this symbol, that is fixed cost divided by CS ratio. So this BEP sales volume also can be found out through PQ. We have already discussed, right? So we have discussed about BEP quantity as well as sales volume, right? And from this level, that is BEP means the minimum amount that you have to sell, so that you can overcome all your fixed cost. According to concept, BEP is the minimum amount that you have to sell to overcome all kinds of fixed cost that you have, right? Or even you can say BEP is the minimum amount that you have to sell when there will be no profit, no loss. Or you can say BEP is the minimum quantity that you have to sell when the contribution and fixed cost will be equal. What's that discussion? Now we'll go through the BEP chart, BEP graph. BEP graph. See? The horizontal axis and this is vertical axis. In horizontal axis we plot unit on equal sale quantity produced and sold out. We'll represent that through the horizontal axis. In vertical axis, through the vertical axis, we plot both cost as well as revenue. Suppose we guys take a decision to start a business, right? We take a decision to start a business. As for example, we are taking this decision, we have taken this decision to produce this kind of pen, right? Before starting production, I need to build up the infrastructure, right? Building an infrastructure. And this is the cost which is associated or incurred before you are starting producing or you are starting any kinds of production. So before any kinds of production, there is a portion of cost which is called fixed cost, right? This portion is fixed cost. We have already, by using this fixed cost, we have built up the infrastructure. Here, infrastructure is built. Now it is our task to start manufacturing these kinds of products. When you are going to produce these kinds of pen, right? Production related variable cost you require, direct material, direct labor, etc. So as a whole, you can say variable cost per unit or marginal cost per unit. That means production related all kinds of variable costs, right? Fixed cost is there, another types of cost is variable cost per unit. So when you are producing zero unit, still your cost is this much, fixed cost. See, the question is, if you shut down your company without starting any kinds of production, your fixed cost remain as a kind of loss. Then, as you are producing more, a constant amount of variable cost will be charged. As for example, suppose you produce one pen. The variable cost to produce one pen is supposed to $2. And fixed cost is suppose, as for example, $10. So if you produce one pen, your total cost is $10 plus $2 variable cost, $12. If you produce two pen, fixed cost will be there $10, But variable cost would be 2 into 2. That means total variable cost increases at a constant rate, then variable cost per unit. That's why
the line will be just like
straight line.
This for sure, this is called variable cost per unit.
So
you can say this portion is your total variable cost, which is called VQ.
So this is variable cost portion and this is fixed portion. If you add these two portions, then it will provide you the total cost portion, right? So you can say this is the TC line, total cost line. We are right now, we are representing the variable cost per unit. But the line is, why? The line is the total cost line. Why? Because the line represents this total portion. And within this total portion, fixed portion is there as well as variable portion is there. So you can say this is total cost line. Clear? We have produced a number of things. Now we step forward to sell these things or sell this commodity in the market. When you reach the market, you do not have any kinds of things or revenue. So revenue starts from zero. As you are selling number of unit, your revenue line will be this much.
This is called TLI, total revenue.
And this is obviously selling price per unit that you are going to set. And this segmented point, this is called BEP point. BEP point. You can ask the question, why this line doesn't go parallel? Why this line segmented upward? Because in setting up the selling price per unit, company always set up the selling price more than the variable cost. That's why here you will always greater than V. That's why the triangular V, or you can say tangent value in radians, actually say radians will be more than here, than here. That's why the line will go upward and tangent in this position. This coordinate is called BEP point, break even point. If you do go below this portion, this is Q. That means at least you have to produce this much unit and at least you have to sell this much unit so that you can reach to the B. And if you look forward this portion, go to the vertical portion, this portion. At this portion we are representing two different lines. One is total cost line, another is total revenue line. This is this portion. This portion. So if you see here, this is total revenue at BP as well as total cost at BP. That's why we start the equation, that means at BP my total revenue and total cost will be equal. Clear the graph? Okay. So what does the graph represent? Now the fact is, see, up to this level, up to this point, your total cost line, this is your total cost line, right? This is your total cost line. And this is your revenue line. See, up to this level, you are covering your total cost. Right? And total cost line is lower than the revenue line. That's why you can say this portion is loss portion. Loss. Loss. When you reach to this position, that means you are covering all kinds of costs through your revenue. Clear? So afterwards, this portion, this is called profit portion. Profit portion. Why? See, here the revenue line, this revenue line is upper than the total cost line. That means you are covering all kinds of cost. Still there are some remaining portion, which is called as a kind of profit. Clear? So if you want to make or generate any kinds of profit, your forecasted sale or budget sale must be more than BEP. Right? That means your budget sale, as for example, this is your budget sale. Budget sale. If your budget sale is less than BEP, in that case you will be in the loss portion, loss of profits. Right? So in the case of managerial post, when you are making any kinds of forecasting, your budget sale obviously more than BP sir. Clear? Now, in this position, there is another conceptual. This is called margin of safety. Why this is margin of safety? Suppose, as for example, your BP quantity is 10 unit, 10 unit. So you budget to produce, suppose, as for example, 25 units, right? Actually, after producing the budget, after setting up the budget to produce 25 units, when your actual production started, your production may be less than the budget. So your production may be 20, maybe 18, maybe 15, but still you are in profit portion. But when you are reaching 10 means there is no profit for loss. So this portion is margin of safety. Margin of safety means from this portion, when you deduct this BP portion, it will provide the margin of safety portion. So you can say margin of safety equal to hazarded cell minus break-even cell. Hazarded cell minus BP cell will produce the margin of safety. And what does margin of safety? Margin of safety represents that portion where the actual cell go down in comparison to budgeted cell, still remain in the profit portion, right? If the actual cell go down, then the budgeted cell still remain in the profit portion. But if your actual cell go more less than BP, then you reach the loss position. Clear? So normally we can say margin of safety equal to hazarded cell minus break-even cell. As for example, our hazarded cell is 25 and break-even cell is 10. So margin of safety is 50. And within the example or in the exam question, this margin of safety actually represented as a kind of percentage of total budgeted cell. So how you can do that? That is 15 divided by 25 into 100. So it will be 25/4, 60. That means you can say within the budget, within your total budget, suppose as for example, this is your BP quantity and this is your budget, right? And this portion is margin of safety. So you can say with the budget, within this budget, this is 60%. That means within the budget, 60% is your margin of safety and 40% is your BP cell. Clear? BP cell. Now the fact is, if this percentage go down, suppose your margin of safety becomes 40%. That means you are squeezing the distance between budget and BP. And when you are reducing the gap between these two, there is a probability of committing loss. Clear? So these are the conceptual part of CVP analysis. Then, so up to this level, we discussed the minimum amount of sales required to appraise yourself at a position where you can overcome all your fixed costs. And after working in the fixed cost, there may be the possibility of profit. Then we talk about the sales volume as well as BP sales volume, BP quantity as well as margin of safety. Now, as you are a businessman, as you are dealing with some business, your main or ultimate focus is generating profit. Right? We started our discussion, that is how much minimum or how many minimum I have to produce and sell to reach at a position when there will be no profit, no loss. Now, being a businessman, my focus is to generate profit. So the question will be, how much or how many I have to sell so that I can construct $100 profit in the next coming period? The question is just like that. So this is called target profit. Target profit. In BEP, we use Q as a kind of quantity. Here, this is target profit quantity. Every cases we are using the same thing. So here the target quantity will be, when you are focusing at BEP, when you are calculating the BEP, in that case you are focusing to overcome only the fixed cost. That's why it was fixed cost divided by contribution per unit. Right? But now you are targeting profit. Profit means after overcoming the fixed cost, still there have some portion to be regarded as a kind of profit. That's why your quantity will be more than the previous one. How much? Or how many? That is fixed cost plus target profit. Clear? So if the question requirement is to find out the quantity that to be sold out to achieve a specific target profit, in that case you can use this formula. So the formula doesn't need to memorize this formula if you understand the concept. If you understand the concept, if the concept is clear, the formula is automatically memorized. So this will provide you the unit. Right? If you are asked what will be the sales volume, what will be the sales volume, if the selling price per unit is Q, then target profit will provide the PU. Right? Or just like the previous, you can find out this sales volume, fixed cost plus target profit divided by CS ratio. It will automatically or directly provide you the total sales volume that you have to go through to find out a specific target profit. Here, so in CVP analysis, what we actually focus. Initially we focus to find out BP, right? BP, here we try to find out BP quantity as well as BP sales volume. BP quantity was fixed cost divided by contribution per unit, or you can say selling price per unit as variable cost. And here, sales volume is if the selling price is P per unit PQ, or you can say fixed cost divided by sales ratio. Right? Then we go through the margin of safety. Margin of safety means that is budgeted sale minus VP sale, that for sure. Right? And the portion normally presented as a kind of percentage of total budget. Then we find out the target profit in this statement, just like the VP, to generate a target profit, the minimum one will be sold out, fixed cost plus target profit divided by contribution per unit, or in dollar, you can say this is PQ, or you can find out full fixed cost plus target profit divided by CS ratio. Here, so this is the summary. In next class, we'll go through some questions regarding this problem solving exercise. Now, one conceptual question that you can see in your exam hall according to the graph, that is, we have discussed, and this graph is very much important, because by providing this graph, you guys may be asked different types of questions. So you have to know the construction process of graph. First of all, this is fixed cost. This is total cost. Here, this is variable cost per unit. Then this is total revenue. Right? This is total revenue. And this ingredients is selling price per unit. Right? This will provide you the BP point, break even. BP point. Now, the fact is, if you go below, this portion is BP quantity. If you go here, this portion represent cost and revenue at BP. The fact is, you guys will be asked a question. What type of question? Suppose all things remain the same. All the things remain the same. If your selling price per unit lessen or reduces, what will be the effect on B? See, this is your selling price per unit line, revenue line. If the selling price per unit reduces, reduces means this ingredients will reduces also, right? So that's why you can assume the line will be just like this one. When your selling price per unit reduces, the ingredients reduces, line will be shifted downwards. In that case, your BP, initial BP quantity is this much. Now your BP quantity is increased the previous one. So you guys will be asked this kind of question. Or if the question is, if your selling price per unit increases, in that case, your BP quantity will be reduced. This is one question. Another question, your variable cost per unit also increases or decreases. If the variable cost per unit decreases, your BP reduces. If your variable cost per unit increases, variable cost per unit increases, in that case your BP also increases. Here, so this type of question you guys will be asked in the exam. This one graph, another graph you can say. In exam one, the graph actually comes through. The graph actually provided in MA2 and as well as F2. So you need to know the graph, concept of graph. In the previous case, earlier stage, we show a portion of fixed cost through a line. In this graph, we will not represent the fixed portion of cost. Rather, we represent this is. This line start from upper level than the origin. So you can assume this is your fixed portion and there is a variable cost also. So as a whole, you can say just like the previous one, this is total cost line. Clear? And another line will be the parallel to this line. Here, this is called total variable cost line. Normally, when you discussed about the cost classification behavior, in there, in the segment of variable cost, total variable cost, we discussed that is variable cost always start from zero. That means if you do not produce any kinds of unit, your total variable cost will be zero. As you are producing number of unit, a constant amount of variable cost per unit will be charged with the quantity produced, right? So that's why in this graph, we represent the variable cost from zero. This is total variable cost line, and another line parallel to this line. This is called total cost line. Why? Because this portion is the fixed portion. So the distance between here, every cases the distance is this portion, which is called fixed portion of cost. So you can say this is your fixed cost. Right? Another way, if this portion is total cost and this portion is variable cost, obviously this portion is fixed cost because total cost is comprised of both variable as well as fixed portion of cost. And there will be a kind of revenue line. Revenue always start from zero. This is your EEP. If you go down, this is quantity. If you go there, it will provide you the cost and revenue line. So the graph may be just like this one than the previous. Clear? Okay. Then another chart you guys may go through, which is called EV chart. EV chart. Or you can say this is profit volume chart. Profit volume chart. This chart actually represents through, yeah. Next class, we'll go through mathematical problems only through this, using this chart. Clear? So today we are going just like the concepts. We are focusing only on the concept. This is zero. At the horizontal axis, we'll plot রেট লিস্ট কলমটা দেখছো যদি খুললাই আমি যে একটা ছেলেকে টাকা দিলাম কিন্তু তো নিয়ে আসে না যদি খুললাই কোথাও পাও যদি চোখের সামনে পড়ে আমার জন্য একটা কলম নিয়ে আসবে এবং সেটা কিন্তু খেয়াল করবা যে দিস ইজ হোয়াইট বোর্ড মার্কার আর একটা পার্মানেন্ট এই যে কলমটা তো দেখছো চেহারাটাই উপর হলো রেট লিফ হোয়াইট বোর্ড মার্কার যদি পাও এটা 90-80 টাকা যদি তোমাদের সামনে পড়ে আমার জন্য একটা কলম নিয়ে আসবে Consecutive sales, you can say dollar or unit. How much, or you can say your buzzer itself, let's say. From zero to lower, according to graph, this is negative portion. Here we plot the fixed cost. Which is a kind of loss, you can say. From zero to upper level, we plot profit, or you can say budgeted profit. Suppose, as for example, in a question, your fixed cost is 10. Your fixed cost is 10. So, suppose this is 5, this is 10, as for example. So, we will plot a point here. This portion is N, which is called fixed cost. Clear? Then your budget sale, suppose as for example, budget sale equal to 100 unit, or you can say $100. This consecutive sale will be present here. Suppose as for example, 10, 20, 30, 40. Suppose this is 100 budget sale. Clear? So we can put this budget cell, volume or unit in this horizontal line. Clear? Now, after calculating, we just assume it. After calculating, suppose your budget profit is just for example 30. Here we plot 5, 10, right? Upper level 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 30. Suppose this is 30. So at budget sale, your budget profit is this much. So if you draw a line through these two coordinates, this portion is profit portion, this portion is loss portion. See, as you are selling up to this level, you are just overcoming your fixed cost. That's where you are in loss position.
at this point,
you overcome all your fixed cost. That's why the line is here, point is here, right? You overcome all kinds of your fixed cost.
This is called BEP.
BEP. And above BEP, your sales or your profit, there will be an amount of profit. That's why we are this point. Here, this is called PV chart. So in your exam, in CVP analysis, you guys may be asked, or you guys may be provided different types of graphical related question depend upon these three graphs.
So the bottom of the
Lampas.